Ratt lead vocalist Stephen Pearcy isn't bothered by their hair metal label. This is the Rock and Roll Weatherman. My name is Sean Morrison. He says he'll embrace it 40 years later, meaning the tag. He's offered his opinion on the label hair metal, the term which was coined in the late 1990s as a way to disparage acts that have been through all the flesh and no substance. He stated on the Twitter platform, and I honestly personally don't refer to it as X, and he said the term hair metal doesn't bother him in the least, as it does some of his peers. Hair metal, think about it, really. He'll embrace the tag 40 years later. It identifies you in the 80s genre forever, which he does bring up a good point. And yes, myself and Janaki do listen to a lot of Sirius XM.
Yes.
You know, Pandora is another thing, you know, but owned by Sirius now, but, you know, and I've always had my discussions of certain bands being played on the hair metal channel, like Screaming Trees, which were never hair metal. Giant. I don't know how Wasp was considered hair metal. I can talk about this forever.
Was Damn Yankees considered?
Later on, they are. Believe it or not, they're getting airplay on Hair Nation, Classic Rewind. I think they're getting airplay on Classic Rewind, Classic Rewind Deep Cuts. I think they get played on all three of them. And even the regular Hair Nation when they play Coming of Age.
Okay, got it.
It's fine by me, but I don't think they were originally a hair metal band. Even Night Rain is being put in there, Crocus. I can write a book about it. And even one of Pearcy's followers disagreed with him, said he would never embrace the term as it was specifically created to marginalize an entire genre of talented musicians. And then all about the music, not the hair. But Mr. Pearcy said, if you're doing business and you're not going to be played on the Sirius XM channel Hair Nation or do shows with the term hair because of the term, I'm not bothered because we kid ready to rat and roll, and that's ours regardless of the association. To be clear, it's rock music unless you're needing it. Friends, if you're not subscribed to the Sean Morrison YouTube channel, please do so. Everyone else out there, subscribe. Thank you much for the continued love, honor, and support. It's greatly appreciated. The use of the term hair metal became widespread after grunge gained popularity at the expense of 1980s metal. Very interesting, though, that's the case. Even Sebastian Bach, as I call him, has his dislike of the term hair metal. Oh, brother.
He does?
Believe it or not, he says, being labeled something that I never set out to be labeled gets under my skin. It's a pain when people try to rewrite history. Believe me, none of us ever set out to be in a hair metal band that did not exist in the 80s. Oh, brother. And apparently in 2012, in an interview with the New York Times, he also acted negatively to the term. He said, I'm the man who put hair in a hair metal. I also headlined Broadway musicals. I acted in millions of TV shows. I didn't get to star in Jekyll and Hyde on Broadway because of my haircut. My voice has gotten me everything in my life, not my hair. Oh, brother. Even Dee Snider has a radio show, I'm thinking of pro wrestling, a radio show called House of Hair for over two decades. And, you know, Dee said for the fans, they didn't find it offensive at all. So, there you go. That's what the show was called. I don't think he named it, though. But still, you know, music is music, you know. I still disagree with some of the bands in the hair metal genre, but that could be another discussion one day. So back to Bradley and vocal Stephen Pearcy. He isn't bothered by the hair metal label, and he'll embrace this tag 40 years later. Your thoughts on Stephen Pearcy not being bothered by the hair metal label? Shame, shame, shame.